What I'd like to do today is to go through a typical workflow for my processing an image in Lightroom. And what I'm going to do is start with this image. It's basically just a typical shot. Didn't come out of camera as good as I would have liked. It didn't quite have the snap and lighting and whatnot that I would like. However, I can make it look a lot better and a lot more sellable with just a few steps in Lightroom. And this is what we're going to go for here. This is the final image that I've already processed, but let's go back to this version, and I'm going to go ahead and start by cropping the image and fixing the angle here. It's a little bit off. I don't like it off so much, so I'm going to go ahead and just tweak it. Now let me go ahead and fix the crop just a little bit and bring this over some more. I'm trying to crop out this area down here that's a little too blown out to fix and bring her a little more centered, but not too centered. I think that's pretty good. I'm good with that. And now I'm going to go ahead and fix the... basically, I want to get the white point where I like it. The camera, I had a custom white balance set up. However, it's still not always exactly where I want it. So I'm going to go ahead and adjust that just a little bit. And let's go ahead and... let's see, a little bit of fill light, just to bring up a little bit of the darker areas. And now I'm actually going to darken the majority of the background by adding blacks. And the blacks are going to really make this green back here just really, really deep, almost black. I mean, you can see by looking at the RGB values over here that we've got, you know, less than 1% in some areas. And that's really going to print really deep, and it helps separate her from the background a lot. Now I'm going to go ahead and, let's see, we've already got the brightness and contrast about where I like them. Those are the default import settings that I have applied to my images typically. And let's add some more vibrance. Let's really bring that up a lot. About 35, 37, that works. And some saturation, about 20, 25% or so. I think that's about where I like it. And in this case, I'm going to add a lot of vibrance and saturation. The vibrance adds color to the real subtle colors, and the saturation adds more color to the deeper, richer colors. I really like using those together in just a limited amount. Don't overdo it. In this case, I like the skin tone I'm resulting here. Not too over the top. It's not, you know, going orange or ridiculous on me. If I went too far with the saturation, she would start to, you know, look sunburnt or have an orange glow to her, and I don't want that. Now let me go ahead. I'm going to actually go up to the adjustment brush, and let's go ahead and set my exposure on that to about zero. I'm going to use brightness instead to brighten up. I'm going to brighten up her face. And the reason I'm doing that is just to make it separate a little better from the background and to give it a little bit of artificial light almost. A little bit of contrast here would help as well. So let's go ahead and pump that up. Maybe not so much. And clarity is always a good tool. Just helps define the features a little bit when used in moderation. I would avoid using clarity on people with wrinkly skin or deep pores or really obvious blemishes and things like that, because it would over exaggerate those. Whereas in this case, she's obviously got baby skin, so it's okay. And just a little bit of sharpness. And I'm just doing a little bit of sharpness selectively on her face so that it makes her... basically just enhances the feature some, and I'm not going to over sharpen the rest of the image. I just want her face to be nice and sharp and really look good. So let's go ahead. I think that's good. I think we've got that area well. Let's zoom in here. Yeah, I'm pretty good with that. We've got this real bright. The face is nice and bright. I could probably actually tone down her shoulder a little bit here, but I think it'll be fine. Now let me go ahead and I'm going to do a little bit of work on her eyes here. Again, I'm going to go back to the adjustment brush, and I'm going to go ahead and set the exposure down some, and I'm going to adjust the brightness. Let's actually bring that up just a little bit, and a little bit of contrast. Actually, let's add a little bit more. Okay, about 50 something, and just a little bit of saturation here. And actually, I don't want clarity this time. I've already added some clarity, so I'm good with that. And just a little bit of sharpness. And I'm actually going to add a little bit of color to the filter here. Oh, let's see. Where do I like this? I think that should be good. Just a little bit of blue, a very close color to what her eyes already are, just to kind of enhance that a little bit. And let's go ahead and do that. Wow, yeah, I like that. And again, with things like the adjustment brush, you can make an adjustment to your settings after you've painted in, so you can see what you're doing while you're working on it. So I can go and then just crank up this and mess with it to see what I'm doing and what I'm getting until I'm happy with those settings. So let's go ahead and set that back. Let's see. Let's go ahead and zoom back out. Looking good. Actually, I want to fix. There's a little, couple little dots here. I'm going to go ahead and use the spot healing brush to fix those. Zoom back out. And now I'm going to fix this image down, area of the image down here where it's a little bit blown out and it's starting to lose detail and it's distracting from the main part of the image here. So I'm going to go ahead and let's go ahead and go down minus one stop. And I'm going to set the rest of these at zero. And I'm going to go ahead and choose a kind of a warm color, just about orange almost. A little bit more saturation to that. And basically just paint over this area. Let's go ahead and do that. And as you can see, it brought the exposure down to basically the rest, match the rest of the background here. And it's also added a slight warm tone to the color here. And the reason why I did that is because it's sunlight hitting the ground there, and it's a pavement, you know, actually I should say cement color ground. So I'm just kind of warming it up and giving it just a nice warm golden tone, just like the filtered sunlight should look through on that ground. So that is basically it. That's pretty much what I do on an image to bring it up to my standards before I would present it to a client. As you can see, the crop is a little bit different, but that was basically the same. I mean, this is a perfectly sellable image. I would present this to anyone, and they would probably be glad to buy, you know, a beautiful large print of her on a canvas or, you know, framed in a collage or whatever. Anyways, if you like this tutorial, please do see the rest of my videos at youtube.com/modifiedphoto and at modifiedphoto.wordpress.com. Thank you for watching.